Wrestling fans, this match is set for one fall. It is for the world's television title. Introducing first, the champion. He weighs in at 249 pounds. From Minnesota, a member of the Four Horsemen, the Enforcer, Arn Anderson.
There's another casualty to throw your head, Sting. Right there.
In the ring, his opponent from Tampa, Florida, at 225 pounds, Lou Perez.
Lou Perez with a great victory on the Power Hour. Now steps in the ring with the Enforcer. And as a matter of fact, we asked Arn Anderson to make some comments about this matchup. Here's what he had to say just before we went on the air.
Lou Perez, you're a tremendous young talent. Tremendous physique, real handsome. But the beating you're going to take today is not at my hands. It's on Sting's head. When you're going to stand up and take that responsibility, I'm the world television champion, bottom line.
Arn Anderson saying that Lou Perez's fate will rest on Sting's head because the Horsemen, as Sid Vicious said earlier, are going to make examples out of everyone they face until they get what they want. And what they want is all the gold, the world title, the U.S. title, the championships back where they say it belongs, and that's in the Horsemen camp.
Unbelievable, Jim, that they would go about that. If you take Lou Perez, Perez, for all we know, may not even know Sting. He may not even know Luger. So why should he have to pay for something? But that's the mentality of the Horsemen. And not only that, now they're saying that, hey, we're going to hurt everybody. We're going to show Luger. We're going to show Sting. What's going to happen to him? Matter of fact, it's already happened to Luger. We're well aware of that.
Obviously, Lou Perez knows professionally Sting and Lex Luger. But personally, you're probably right, Bob. They may not be the best in pals, but he may have to pay the price. And Arn Anderson starting off in a very frustrating mode as far as Lou Perez is concerned, pulling the hair in this battle for the World TV Championship. Fans, I'll be talking tomorrow night at 6:05 in the NWA main event with Nature Boy Ric Flair about his matchup at the Clash of Champions with Lex Luger for the U.S. title also tomorrow night. Brad Armstrong, the Candyman, takes on Barry Windham in a special danger zone. It will be Paulie Dangerously talking to Lex Luger, and I'll be talking to Sting and Luger before we go off the air here too, time permitting. And Anderson with a knee to the midsection, and that left hand found its mark.
Well, he's got a powerful left hand. He's naturally left-handed, and he packs a lot of power in that left of his.
Perez showing great tenacity, a couple of scoop slams and a drop kick, and the television champion a little bewildered at that show of offense by Lou Perez.
I think he sort of caught him by surprise that he was that quick. I don't think really that Arn Anderson realized just how quick he was.
You know, Bob, quite bluntly, Lou Perez has everything to gain in this
Absolutely.
Match and nothing to lose. And I can tell you that this young man came here on his debut on World Championship Wrestling to wrestle for the biggest title that he's ever competed for. And he's, I don't think, intimidated. He's very focused on what he came to do.
Absolutely. He's ready for it. He's ready for that championship match. And Arn Anderson may be just the other way. He really may not have been prepared for this young man.
I find it hard to believe that the Enforcer would not be mentally prepared. But, of course, they have been focused on the dudes with attitudes, Sting, Lex Luger, and company. But as Anderson said in his interview that we heard moments ago, their focus is on Sting and the World's Heavyweight Championship. And everyone that they step into the ring, they, meaning the Horsemen, will be made an example of until they get the match they want. They want Luger. They want Sting. And they want the championships to be on the line when they face the Horsemen. Careful by Arn Anderson, but Lou Perez held on. Good move and good concentration there by the youngster.
Jim, let's remind all our fans around the New York area, World Championship Wrestling on Friday, the 24th of August, going to be in the Meadowlands. That's 8 p.m. in the Meadowlands, and tickets are available through Ticketmaster.
It's going to be a great one in East Rutherford, New Jersey, and all the fans in the tri-state area, hope they'll be with us in the Meadowlands on Friday night, August the 24th. Anderson went for the elbow, but Perez very quick. One of his great attributes will be his quickness in this contest.
Well, he's shown Anderson before just how quick he was, and then on an elbow drop, he got out of it. He wasn't even anywhere close to it.
Should have never made that mistake.
Well, it takes a lot of speed and a lot of quickness. Jim, and we've talked about that before. That's something you can't learn. They don't teach you that. You're born with that speed and that quickness. You either got it or you'll never have it.
Collar and elbow tie up, and Anderson with the advantage. Arn Anderson going downstairs with that left hand, and now upstairs with it. He is a very tough customer, no doubt about it, and can really use the DDT. But there is Lou Perez, and Anderson, oh, what an adjustment he made. Inverted atomic drop, and the tide has turned.
At times when you think you've got everything going your way, and that you've really got him in trouble, that's when he'll come back and be the toughest on you. Jim, that's a fighter that's always thinking. He always knows what's happening in the ring. And he always works within himself.
You know, we've talked about the attributes of the Horseman, Anderson, Windham, obviously the incomparable Nature Boy Ric Flair, in the estimation of many, and this broadcaster as well, the greatest world champion of all time. All those men I mentioned will be and are great challengers for Sting's world title. But the big guy.
There you go.
6'9", 338. I think that's the man that they're grooming perhaps for the world's heavyweight championship. That is, in case Flair doesn't beat Sting in the meantime, which could very, very definitely happen.
There's no doubt. Right now, they got to be ranked as the most awesome group in all of sports, Jim.
If you look at the top 10 contenders, the Horsemen probably would occupy perhaps the top four spots in many polls. And right there, Lou Perez trying to get a sunset flip on Arn Anderson, but he met that big left hand again, and the left hand has been a very prime weapon of Arn Anderson in this television championship event.
And Arn Anderson showing you that he had the power to withhold that sunset flip, and that took a lot of power and strength on his part.
Anderson the neck vise on Lou Perez. Fans, don't forget, here next week on this program at 6:05. Bob, we've got a great tag team matchup, a dream tag team match in the eyes of many.
Flying Brian and the Z-Man and the Midnight Express. What a match that's going to be, Jim. I'm really looking forward to that one, and I know all you fans that want to see it, don't miss it. Next week, right here, 6:05 on TBS.
Anderson, after tossing Perez out on the floor, follows him out. Got him right up against that pole, and Anderson hit the pole with a clothesline. Now, this may be the break, no pun intended, that Perez was looking for. Let's see if he can take advantage.
I had just started to say that this is where Arn Anderson could probably do some of his most dangerous work.
Perez sends him to the near side, catches him with a drop kick. Nice move. He's got him covered. Lateral press. A near fall there. The television champion in trouble as Lou Perez sends him for the ride one more time. Elevates him on top again with a lateral press. And again, Anderson kicks out.
Perez senses it right now, though, Jim. Look how quick he is back to the attack.
The adrenaline is really flowing on the young challenger from the Sunshine State of Florida. Perez with those right hands. And again, Anderson tried an atomic drop. Perez blocks it, but he got him right there. Waist lock into the spine buster. And Arn Anderson has just finished it off. Indeed, he has. The Horsemen are dominant.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match is still World Television Champion Enforcer, Arn Anderson.
Yes, sir, fans, and Arn Anderson coming on for a good win over an outstanding-looking youngster in Lou Perez.
Another one down.